Rick and Morty presents Jerry Baree. We started with a Rick telling a bunch of Jerrys in a bus that they're about to enter the most fun place in the multiverse. But if there's one thing he knows about Jerrys, is that the more fun something is, the more likely it is to kill them. Rick says that if any of them die, he'll clone them so that the Ricks don't find out and demand a refund. That's really smart of him. Maybe the whole Jerry daycare mascara was covered up with that, so the families didn't get too upset. So why is Rick bringing a bunch of Jerrys to Blips and Chits? Too bad the art gets amateurish. This isn't a fan comic, so why is the art style changing within the same issue? Jerry isn't good at the trivia arcade game because he's not familiar with the alien culture, so he's tricked by a bunch of trick questions. I don't buy that 3 would be the wrong answer when it's called Gear Wars. And propaganda isn't literally a weapon. Weapons hurt people. He keeps getting the answers wrong, and the arcade machine calls him a gyrophobe and stamps his forehead with the insult. Because he assumed the war was about something other than mere gears. That's frustrating. I guess it was trying to be satisfying because it's Jerry. But it's not like he's getting smacked around. Just being the victim of some unfair nonsense. Then he sees someone in a simple machine begging to press a button and let him out. We see a bold Jerry ask, "What's this?" and see a normal Jerry run around under a small dome. Jerry says he won that confusing game and says he can't do anything, and punches a punching bag that says "Ow" and asks tearfully why he did that. It turns out it was a game called Caress the Sack, and yet we see the alien on the picture hug the sack, not just caress it. Jerry is called sick as the living sack's taken out of order, when they should have expected the confusion because it looks like a punching bag. I can't help but feel sorry for this Jerry. He can't have any fun because none of the games are intuitive. I love that every Jerry has a shirt on with the name of their dimension written on it. And it takes forever to give every dimension actually an indicative name. So it's just a letter and numbers. It's shorter than actually giving them a proper name. It'd probably take forever to write down every difference. So who decided what the names of every dimension would be? How is there a universal consensus? I guess the Council of Ricks decided. I guess the Citadel of Ricks got together and standardized names. And all of the Ricks confirmed to those names for the portal guns for the sake of everyone understanding each other on it. Because realistically, every portal gun would name their dimension differently. How is anyone supposed to go to, say, Dimension 198, and know it's called that? Especially when Rick first invented the portal gun and didn't have a chance to meet the other Ricks yet. Jerry tries to play a life simulation game, where he ends up being a little boy. And because he's confused and tells the mother in the game who he really is, and asks how he got here, the woman says there's a demon inside him, even though he's not acting evil. I guess he was wrong genre-savvy and assumed that putting the helmet on literally transported him to another dimension. So he wanted to get help. But since his body looked different, and he clearly started playing a virtual reality game, he should have known better. What did he think the glasses would do? So somehow the game has him die immediately because the father's idea of exorcism was using an axe. Jerry goes to a fortune teller machine and asks which games won't hurt him in any way. Again, he's being really relatable here, and ironically, sometimes that's one of his character's strengths. He's given a little note saying Logan will be here soon, and then when he asks who Logan is, he gets another note saying that Logan will not be happy and is about to beat him. This doesn't make any sense. Who wouldn't ask who Logan is? I don't get it, was this specifically set up by Rick? He insults the machine, calling it stupid and useless because it is, and the alien says that's his wife and hits Jerry. But there's gore, and I didn't get to see the fists actually collide with him, so how is that satisfying? Jerry lampshades to one of the Jerrys trying to comfort him that the games are almost certainly illegal. So he's told that the game over there is actually pretty uplifting. And it turns out it's Grief Counselor Taxi. A woman gets into the taxi he's driving in the game, and I guess he's lying when he says he lost his kids a couple years back. But he's tearing up, so maybe he's not lying. And he literally did lose Summer and Morty. It's not our Jerry after all. He says he'll never get over what happened, and we see Rick and Beth comfort him uncharacteristically as I wonder why the hell Rick didn't just clone his Summer and Morty to replace them right away and lie about it. I guess they died in front of Beth and Jerry so he couldn't, but wait, he could erase their memories. Well, I guess they died in front of a lot of people and not just Beth and Jerry. He says that she should let her loved ones comfort her. After she's comforted by the advice, he stupidly turns and faces her while driving and drives into a limo, which ends up killing the woman's father in an accident. Good thing it's just virtual reality, but still, that was depressing. I wish it was established that this Jerry in particular did a lot of awful things to deserve all of this. Then we see another Jerry get a bunch of tickets up to a desk because he wants a pill that gives you the powers of a god for 90 seconds. That wouldn't exist. No one would take the risk of putting it where anyone can eventually get all the tickets and get it. It's just baffling. Of course, I was excited to see what he'd do with the pill right away, but still. And he actually explains how he got all those tickets. He beat tiny versions of himself playing Whack-A-You, killed for more tickets, made out with a bowl of mac and cheese, passed a Michigan bar exam, and almost died playing skee-ball. Out of nowhere, he's told that he only has enough for a keychain that is a personal self-destruction device, which the alien didn't care enough to warn him not to use. And somehow he was allowed to sell it in the first place. I guess there's a very casual attitude to suicide, Futurama style in its culture, but come on. All that build up to nothing. Then a Jerry pulls him into a photos booth where they try to goof off, and the word gyrophobe somehow magically disappears in one of the panels, which was distracting. Then somehow they just get a note saying that they'll die today. Jerry says he can't take this anymore, and screams hitting the button on a machine, and somehow wins 10 billion tickets in a row. Why can't the guy who did a lot to earn the tickets get a lot of tickets? I guess the reason Morty loves blips and chits is that Rick cares enough about him to tell him which games he'd actually like to play, and make sure he doesn't play the games he'd hate. With Jerry, it's different. Jerry eats a god pill and goes Super Saiyan, just to see a bunch of bad things happen at Jerry's all at once. He says that to be a Jerry is to live a life of endless punishment. He could have a lot worse, though. He could have it like Morty. At least he's not dirt poor. Jerry says that he won't let his kind continue to suffer. So is he gonna kill all of the Ricks because the Ricks are what bother the Jerrys? I wonder how they're gonna get out of giving him what he wants. Because that breaks the status quo, so we can't have that. Out of nowhere, he decides that there should be no more Jerrys. Instead of actually giving them happy lives. Huh? But he's a Jerry. Well, it was needlessly gory to see what happened to all the Jerrys in the place. And thankfully, it was only the Jerrys in this place, somehow, despite him having the power of a god. I did actually think it was funny that Rick fell to his knees and said, "No! I have to make 157 Jerry clones? Damn it!" He uses his portal gun to go to a cloning machine and says that he hates his job. This story was about a Jerry from the Jerry daycare being made miserable because he was arbitrarily brought to Blips and Chits by a Rick. I guess it was specifically for the purpose of tormenting Jerrys, considering how ridiculously badly it went for him. It didn't go so badly for Morty or Hemminger's friends. Sometimes it made sense, but sometimes it was just suspicious. Like when he pressed the self-destruct button, he got a surprise. And why was there a god pill there? Why did he decide to kill the Jerrys around him instead of... I guess it was just impossible to give them all happy lives free of conflict, and he couldn't imagine that at all. I guess his point was that Jerrys are suffering regardless of whether Rick's doing it or not. But still. It made sense that Jerry wouldn't know the answers to a trivia game about alien war, but it didn't make sense that he would bail the virtual reality machine by thinking he was smart to tell the person who thinks he's someone else who he really is right away. Why did he look back at that person when he was driving? There's only so stupid someone can be. Still, it was constantly interesting seeing all the different arcade games in that place. It made sense that a futuristic arcade game would have so many virtual reality games. And it was smart of Rick to have a cloning machine for the Jerrys. But I don't buy that this is the canon way that Blips and Chips is. If it was the most fun place in the multiverse, you'd think most of it wouldn't suck.